Okay, today's lab, we'll be talking about some IPv6 related stuff, and we're going to configure a network that has a mixture of IPv4 and IPv6 stuff in it. If you guys can hear that noise or not, but it's my dog walking downstairs. Okay, so anyway, we're going to configure this mixture of IPv4, IPv6 network. If it says IPv4 and IPv6, we'll put both on it. If it's IPv4 only, we'll just put IPv4 on it, and we're only going to configure the router interfaces for the protocols listening on that interface. So this router interface will have both an IPv4 and an IPv6 address. This router interface will only have an IPv4 address since it says IPv4 only. This router interface will have IPv4 and IPv6. This router interface will only have IPv6. IPv6 and IPv4 out here on two separate hosts, but we still need both IPv4 and IPv6 on this interface, IPv4 and IPv6 on that interface. And then we'll connect our routers together with crossovers, and then we will configure IPv6 on this each of these interfaces. The lab sheet says some stuff, thing I just said. It says configure your core network, the networks between your routers, to have only IPv6 addresses. Well, that's not going to work for IPv4. It says, is it possible to route IPv4 traffic across your IPv6 core? Well, that's not going to work. So we will need to, before it's all going to work, we need to put IPv4 addresses on the routers as well, on the interfaces between the routers, IPv4 and IPv6. And we also need to enable and configure an IPv4 and IPv6 a routing protocol. So we will do all that stuff. And then we'll see what works just for fun. So subnetting on this is going to be probably problematic for you guys because some of you guys are terrible at subnetting. So is there like a tool I can draw a picture with? Yeah, whatever. I don't know. I don't know. Anyway, so every router interface. Let me see how I want to phrase this. Every segment needs to be its own subnet in both IPv4 and IPv6. So this router interface and this PC would be one segment, so that'll be one subnet. This interface and this PC will be a different segment, so that would be a different subnet, right? This will just be IPv6 subnet. Same thing over here. This is one segment, so we have a different subnet from anywhere else. This is a segment over here, this is a segment over here, and this is a segment over here. These router-to-router links are the same segment, so those need to be on the same subnet. So I'm gonna go through and configure it probably, but just wanted to mention that you might have some problems with your subnets. Some of you probably will. You should know. You should know how to do this by now. So anyway, let's get started. In my template file, I didn't connect things because I want to make sure you guys know how to connect things. So I'll go ahead and connect some stuff. Straight through from a PC to switch, straight through from switch to router. All right. Straight through from switch to router. Straight through from PC to switch. We're not going to do any VLANs in this lab, so you don't have to worry about what ports you're plugging your switches into and what VLANs. And then between your routers, we're going to want crossovers. That's not what I wanted. I was going to use a different interface for that. Between the routers, we want crossovers. So that's the first part of the connections. Everything else will mirror. Straight throughs down here, crossovers up there. For the config, we'll configure our PC for an IPv4 address. I'll use, good old 1.2 and 1.1 for my IPv4 address on this interface, this PC. And for the IPv6 address, you go over here and configure it. IPv6 config, we're going to do static. Sorry. You go to the interface settings to put the IP address. We're going to do static for IPv6. All right. And we're going to use stuff that starts with FC01:1, right? Because one, colon, colon, 2/64. So if we recall from our studies of IPv6 before, these two colons mean a whole bunch of zeros, right? So this address really, if you wrote the whole thing out, is FC01, colon 1, colon 0, colon 0, colon 0, colon 0, colon 0, colon 0, colon 2, which should get us to 8 groups of characters, I think. So this first part is going to be my network ID, and this last part is going to be my host ID. So my next network, I'll make FC012 and FC013 and FC014, et cetera, et cetera. So I put the IPv6 address over here. I go back over here to put the IPv6 gateway, which is going to be FC01:1:1. So that's what I'm going to set the IPv6 gateway to on the router. So that's the settings on the PC, on the router. We configured, what's that, 0.0.0 is going to be that interface. So we need to go into the interface configuration. Why is that not working? My headphone cord was getting in the way, so that's why I paused. So I need to configure FA00. I'm going to give it an IP address for IPv4 of 192.168.1.1. I'm going to give it an IPv6 address of FC01:1:1/64. And I'm going to do no shutdown. So now that link should be up. And once Spanning Tree finishes, I should be able to do some stuff. So we'll try to ping our gateways. I can ping my IPv4 gateway, and I don't know, is this a ping 6 or just ping? Yeah, ping. If I ping my IPv6 gateway, that should work also. So there you go. I've established connectivity from my single IPv4, IPv6 host I've configured so far to the router interface. So now I just need to go through and configure everything else. I was going to just configure it all in advance, but I figured, you know, some of you guys like watching me work. So I'm going to go ahead and record the podcast while I'm configuring everything. If you think you know what you're doing and you're bored, then you can skip ahead to when I'm done and testing stuff. But if you like watching me work, then you can watch me work. And I'm going to start some music to accompany me while I work to keep me interested in this. So let's go. You ready? So you notice I did IPv4 only on that interface because it only has an IPv4 host. So if it's only an IPv4 host, I only need to do IPv4. Yeah, I was hoping I was gonna finish before that finished, but I didn't. So I'll start it back over. No, 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 no. That was darn near perfect timing. So there we go. So now I have IP addresses on everything, which took me about, oh, it was about 9 minutes, I guess, because that music clip was 4 minutes and 34 seconds long, and I went through it twice. So I have IP addresses on everything. So at this point, I should be able to ping locally. I should be able to ping from this PC to that router interface. Let's try that for fun. I don't remember what I called this guy. FC014, FC, so I'm ping, FC01:4:1. Hey, I can ping my router interface. At this point, I have not enabled any routing protocols across the network, so I'll go ahead and do that for IPv4, because we know how to do that. We'll just use RIP, because we're feeling kind of lazy. At least I am. Oops. So we'll do, let's do show IP in brief, so we can see what networks we have. We have 1, 2, 10, and 11, so we need to do router RIP. Router RIP. RIP. Version 2, because we know that's superior to version 1, and we need to add some networks. 192.168.1.0, 2.0, 10.0, and 11.0. So I do my router RIP for that guy. Do show IP int brief. Into brief, and we have 3 IPv4 networks on this router, because down here we only have IPv6 only, so there's no IPv4 network off that router interface. So router RIP version 2, some networks, 3.0, 10.0, and 12.0. Then over here, exit, do show IP int brief, 5, 6, 12, and 11. So router RIP version 2, network 5, 192.168.5.0, 6.0, 12.0, and 11.0. So at this point, we should have some routes in our network. Show IP route. Show IP routes. We have a bunch of RIP routes. Great. 10.0 is possibly down. That's no good. RIP's being a pain. So anyway, at this point, we should be able to ping all of our IPv4 addresses. So the lab sheet, if I can find it. The lab sheet says, blah, 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 blah. Attempt to ping from the following. Ping from an IPv4-only host to an IPv4-only host. That's going to work. Ping from an IPv4-only host to an IPv4 and IPv6 host. That'll work. Ping from an IPv4 host-only host to an IPv6-only host. That's not going to work. So the short version is, as long as the host you're trying to connect uses the same protocol, IPv4 or IPv6, you will be able to connect. If they don't use the same protocol, then you won't be able to connect. So before we do that, we need to configure IPv6 routing protocol. First off, we have to tell our router to route IPv6. By default, routers won't route IPv6. So I tell it, hey, yo, I want you to route IPv6 traffic. Then we have to enable RIP for IPv6. And first thing we have to do is to specify that we want it to be a RIP router, and we specify tip RIP, and we specify a name to be the tag that we reference when we enable it on each interface. So in this case, we'll just call it, you know, IP6. So now that we've created that, we have to go into each interface we want to be doing routing for IPv6. And say IPv6 RIP, and then the name we created, RIP. Our name was IP6, and then enable. So we need to do that for each interface that has IPv6 off of it. So yeah, so that'd be all of them at this point on this router. Now we'll go down here and we'll do it on all of them. So IPv6 router. Oh, hey, that command's not working. I'm hitting tab and it's like, I don't know what you're talking about, fool. Because I didn't tell it was a unicast router yet. IPv6 router. Router. Or it didn't tell me because I didn't type in enough letters for that to work. Because we have route and router. So apparently I just didn't type in enough letters. Router. RIP. And then IP6. And then we need to go into each interface and enable it. IPv6. B6. RIP. IP6. Enable. All right, so that should be good for that guy. So now, in theory, if we show IPv6 route, hopefully we have some IPv6 routes that we learned. Local connected. Apparently we didn't learn any yet. All right, we'll wait a minute and see if those guys start working. Let's go configure this router. IPv6 router, RIP, IP6, oh, yeah, you're right, IPv6, unicast, routing, and FA00, IPv6, RIP, IP6, enable. All right, so that should be the config that is required. So now let's see if we have any routes. Show IP route. Shows our IPv4 routes. That's working, mostly. Show IPv6 route. Hey, we have some RIP routes from IPv6. So now, in theory, we should be able to ping across between our different hosts that support the same protocol. Show IPv6 route. Ta-da! So we have some RIP routes. So now, from this guy, I should be able to ping any of my IPv4 addresses. So I have 192.168.2.2. All right, 3.2, did I have a 3.2? Yeah, I think that's 3.2. I don't have a 4.2 because this is 4 down here, IPv6 only. Have a 5.2 and a 6.2. 5.2. And I have a 6.2. Ah! What the hell was that? 6.2. So this host does IPv4 and IPv6. From IPv4, we can ping any of the IPv4 supporting computers, right? If we try to ping IPv6 supporting computers, I don't have a 2 because that's IPv4 only. I have pretty much everything else. So if I ping FC01:3:2, that'll hopefully work. Or not. All right, so we can ping our gateway still. Let's try that. We can ping our gateway. Let's go So I'm going to check this guy. IPv6 config. Config. Ping FC01 colon 33 colon colon 1. All right, we can ping that gateway. So why can't I ping between them? I have a router rip out FA11. That's where it's going out this way. There must be a problem here. Let's see, 10. 10 is 10.1, and this has 10 as 10.2. I ping myself a minute ago. I didn't ping my router. My router is 1. I can ping that too. I'm ping 3.1. Ping 10.1. That's my router. The other router. All right, there's something wrong between here. This is 10 and 10. 10 has FC01 10 colon colon 1. This 10 has FC01 colon 10 colon colon 2. I can ping between those guys, right? Ping FC01 colon colon 10 like colon 10 colon colon 2. Yeah, weird. I don't know. C3. So I can ping that PC from there. That's weird. Let's go to try to ping somewhere else from IPv6. Let's try to ping 3 from here. 3, 3, 2. Oh, I don't have enough letters. There we go. So I can ping from here over to here. See if I can ping 1. When destination host unreachable. 4 colon colon 1. This is a. Four one. Alright, so show IPv6 route. So you have a route for 1. So I don't have a route for FC01 colon colon 1 in my routing table. So maybe I didn't configure RIP properly on this guy. So let's look. Oh, sure enough. See this? I didn't do that on FA00. So hey, look at that. You just got a little free troubleshooting. I don't know what you want to call it. You got to watch me do some unintended. I totally screwed that up so that you could watch the troubleshooting process you should follow if some of your stuff's not working. I totally did that on purpose. It was not at all a mistake. I know I did a really good job acting like I didn't know what was going on so I could troubleshoot that. But yeah, that was totally, totally on purpose. Now I should be able to ping 3. Hopefully. Hey, check that out. Oh, that was so beneficial for you guys that I intentionally set that up. So At this point, hopefully everything's working. So let's look at what I want to look at on the lab paper. It says, ping from IPv4 only to IPv4 only, IPv4 only to IPv4 and IPv6. Those will work. Number three won't work. All right, so if we go try to ping something that only has an IPv6 address, well, if it only has an IPv6 address, you have to ping the IPv6 address, right? Wait, that's not one. I want an IPv4 only. It's this guy. So say I want to ping IPv6 only. I want to ping this guy. Ping FC01:4:2. All right. It says it's sending, but I don't know how it's sending because we don't have an IPv6 address. So that's probably just the way the simulator was programmed. It probably would give you a different error in the real world, like general failure or something like that. So that won't work. Another thing you can't do if you're on a if you're on an IPv4 and an IPv6 host. Wait, that's not what I'm trying to say. What am I trying to say? Yeah, I don't know where I was going with that. So anyway, that's how to get it set up and configured. And then go through these different steps and see what's possible with the config. And then we want to collect some output commands already ran. Show IPv6 route, show IPv6 interface brief, show IP route, and show IP interface brief. Save your simulator file for submission and answer some questions and blah, blah, blah. Turn some stuff in. Sounds like fun, huh? So, that's that.